Welcome to the Nevis Newscast for Friday, May 14th, 2021. I am Fredicia Liebert. The Medical University of the Americas, MUA, and the Nevis Island Administration, NIA, have issued a call for the MUA-NIA scholarships for the 2021-2022 cycle. The MUA and NIA will offer two scholarships to well-deserving high school graduates with a sound academic record. Scholarships will be awarded towards the pursuit of undergraduate studies which lead to a degree at an accredited university or higher learning institution. The scholarships can be awarded for up to 4 years of study at University of the West Indies, any four-year United States-based institution, or the Medical University of the Americas. The priority areas include environmental health, optometry, dental hygiene, occupational or speech therapy, nursing, health education, biomedical engineering, health information management, occupational health and safety, radiography supply chain management in health, or social work. MUA-NIA scholarships will be awarded to begin studies in August 2021 to February 2022. Candidates must be at least 18 years of age, be a citizen of St. Kitts and Nevis, have at least 5 CSEC passes including mathematics, English and one science, and be active in community service. Applications will be accepted from Monday, May 17, 2021 to Friday, June 25, 2021. They must be typewritten and submitted in hard copy to Chairperson MUA-NIA Scholarship Committee in care of the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Health, Administration Building, Charlestown, Nevis. Questions about the eligibility and other matters regarding the application process can be forwarded to min.health@nia.gov.com or to Permanent Secretary Shalissa Martin Clark at 469-5521 extension 6490. The Honorable Troy Liebert recommitted the support of the Ministry of Education to the Federation's schools when he spoke at a workshop for secondary school principals on Friday, May 14th. The Honorable Troy Liebert is the Junior Minister of Education in the Nevis Island Administration.
Yeah, I know we have our colleagues from over on the island of St. Kitts here with us this morning, so I felt like I wanted to take the opportunity to come over and show that support. We, of course, are one federation. Whatever happens here in Nevis affects what happens on St. Kitts, and what happens on St. Kitts likewise affects us over here in Nevis. I know over the past year plus, we have had quite a challenging time. We have been going through the new syllabus, the experience with the changing the syllabus and so on, and then we also had the COVID-19 pandemic. So it has been quite a challenging time for us in education.
He noted that the past year has been particularly challenging for secondary schools.
Here on Nevis, we are still in a situation where both of our government-owned high schools, they're still on the shift system. From all of the indications, it has been working out quite well, but it is still a challenge for the principal and for the staff of the various schools. So I just wanted to be here to show that solidarity with all of you, to let you know that those of us in the ministry and, of course, at the government level, that we understand what the challenges are. And so as much as possible, where we can help, we are happy to do that.
Junior Minister of Education, the Honorable Troy Liebert. Premier of Nevis and Minister of Tourism, the Honorable Mark Brantley, is encouraging persons to support the new initiative dubbed Around the Garden Tour, a collaboration between the Ministry of Agriculture and the Nevis Tourism Authority. The Premier was speaking at the launch following his tour on Thursday, May 13th, 2021.
I am really delighted that I had the chance this morning to experience Around the Garden Tour. This is a new development here at Cades Bay, where we have had a collaboration between tourism and agriculture to produce a farm that people can come to, a leisure farm, where they can pick fruits, they can get smoothies, they can relax. And I think that this is a welcome addition to our tourism product. The tour that we had this morning was very informative. I think that we really enjoyed seeing the variety of fruits that are available here, seeing all that Nevis has to offer, and I would invite everyone to come and visit this farm at Cades Bay. I think it is truly a wonderful addition, and I congratulate the Ministry of Agriculture, the Honourable Minister and Deputy Premier Alexis Jeffers, of course, Mr. Huey Sargent, the Permanent Secretary, and also the Ministry of Tourism and the Nevis Tourism Authority for their leadership on making this particular project happen. I look forward to seeing people here. I think it's a great idea, and certainly I ask people to come and visit.
The initiative formed part of the celebration for Agriculture Awareness Day 2021, which is being held under the theme, Eat Locally, Boost Immunity.
And our tourism industry, on which we rely so heavily, has really suffered. We have therefore been forced to sort of shift our focus.
The details right after this break.
The Nevis Water Department is getting ready to launch a new app, making it easier for customers to pay online. We've heard all the complaints, and the department has made moves, made calls to build a platform that will be easily accessible for our customers. We are getting ready to launch our ePay app. Yes, you've heard right. ePay is coming soon to the Nevis Water Department. Stay tuned. Keep your ears and eyes locked. The Nevis Water Department is here to provide you with exceptional service.
Welcome back. The Ministry of Tourism is seeking to professionalize its offerings in terms of services to the island's visitors and locals alike. Premier and Minister of Tourism, the Honourable Mark Brantley, made that assertion on Wednesday, May 12th, at the close of the Ministry's Small Business Entrepreneurship Workshop.
We see each person as a valuable customer to be offered the same quality of service, the same quality of product. And that, I think, is ultimately what we're seeking to do at the Ministry of Tourism, is to ensure that our standards are maintained. And that is what is critical for us, that we ensure that throughout the whole service spectrum, that everybody that people come into contact with, whether they're local tourists, if there's such a term, or the tourists coming in from a boat, or the tourists coming in from a plane, whoever they come into contact with, the quality is the same.
The theme of the workshop was fostering domestic tourism, making tourism work for me.
For the past year, the country has essentially been locked down in terms of COVID-19 and our response to it. And as a result of that, our tourism product has suffered, and our tourism industry, on which we rely so heavily, has really suffered. We have therefore been forced to sort of shift our focus, and we have looked a lot at what we're referring to as the domestic tourism. We have, as you might have seen, done a lot of promotions where we're talking about staycation. That's a word now in everybody's vernacular. Everybody's talking about staycations. Our hotels have come on board, our restaurants have come on board, our water taxi operators have come on board. And we see on many long weekends the place is flooded over here because lots and lots of our sisters and brothers from St. Kitts come over. That is not by accident, that is by design. That is because we have been actively promoting this idea of domestic tourism. So in a very real way, it has already started to work. It's already bearing fruit.
Premier and Minister of Tourism, the Honourable Mark Brantley. A man who entered the Federation on Tuesday without passing through a legal port of entry and was apprehended by the police Thursday morning is a national of St. Kitts and Nevis. The man, who was found sometime after 3 a.m. on May 13th in a house in the Buckley's development area in St. Kitts, has been placed at a government-designated quarantine site under guard. Police Superintendent Cromwell Henry disclosed Thursday afternoon that the COVID-19 test result for the suspect was negative. He will be tested again at the end of 14 days. The search for the man began on Tuesday, May 11th, after the police received information about a fishing vessel landing at Lime Keel Bay and an individual with a suitcase getting off the vessel and running into the Lime Keel village area. The vessel was taken into custody by the St. Kitts and Nevis Coast Guard. Investigations so far have revealed that it was stolen in Antigua and Barbuda on May 10th. That's it for this edition of the Nevis Newscast. On behalf of all of us here at the Department of Information, I'm Freddie Silibird. Thank you for viewing.